Greenwood at one time was a giant place.
40 plus blocks was owned, operated by African Americans.
Everything was rich in Tulsa. It was the oil capital of the world. This was money, 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 money.
It became known as Black Wall Street.
We didn't need to go across the tracks.
They hated the prosperity.
Dick Rowland was accused of attacking a white lady in the elevator.
The white people thought it was only right for this black boy to get hung who had done no crime.
And they were gonna try to lynch him that night.
We pose a threat and you have to do something about it because you can't imagine black people doing things on their own.
They were not going to let that boy get hung.
Fight broke out.
And like one guy told me, man, we almost had him. He said, we had him. Until they started coming around with them airplanes and dropping Molotov cocktails and on Standpipe Hill, and they had the machine guns. He said, man, we couldn't compete with that.
My great-grandfather talked about some kind of tragedy that went on. And one day, he said, I killed a white man.
Older guy, probably around 60, maybe 70, set us down and told us how important it was, the land that we were standing on was holy.
I think it's a concerted effort by the government. It was too organized.
We actually rebuilt after that.
What stands out when you think of Greenwood is community.
Greenwood was a full city for black people.
So I remember the businesses. I remember that we didn't have to go out of our neighborhood for anything.
They call it urban renewal, but we call it urban removal.
They wanted to break up the concentration of areas, so they built freeways.
Everything was closed up. It was destroyed once again by the government.
Now on Greenwood Avenue, there's only one block of businesses that remain.
Definitely there needs to be more unity within the black community.
Years of distrust, years of not working with each other.
Build one another up and work with one another. That's how Greenwood was constructed. People working in unity, having one vision.
So we have to be told these things over and over again in order for the younger generation to buy into it. And if that doesn't happen, they won't buy into it, and it'll be a lost thing forever.